You said yours was 2004. You're hoping
2002.
Yeah. And you're hoping
like it works. And computer said that this sensor, and he took this. Okay, whatever. I don't know because I'm not mechanic, you know.
Yeah, when I Googled it, like all I did was I took the part number, and I Googled it, and I still have it on. My phone dialed out. Yeah, see, I took it and I Googled it. It was a Hugo 13855, and it's an ignition Bosch. It's an ignition module.
Ignition module.
That's what that part number said online.
Wow. Okay.
So if that's what you need, but what did the computer say that you needed? Did it say the ignition module, or did it say the mass airflow sensor?
He said, computer said mass flow sensor, and he replaced that one. Okay, let me talk to my mechanic.
Well, let's figure out what code your engine is, because that could make the. Oh, you don't have it in there.
There is a book, maybe.
Yeah, the owner's manual will have it on it. Or you can even pop a trunk, it'll say it right in the trunk. Because okay. Different engine code will be different. See, you'll have a build sheet right in here. Right here. Mm-hmm. And it says... That's a... GLS, no, AWM, AWM, right there. Yeah, AEB is what mine is, with the DDT transmission for 99 Passat. But it'll also have it right on that, the first few pages of your owner's manual, it'll have it right on the sticker. Yeah, see, it has that GLS. Yeah, there. So yeah, it's the same thing. That was the same thing as the build sheet on this, okay. In case you ever lost this or whatever.
Okay.
But yeah, if you plugged it into the computer and it said you need a new mass airflow sensor,
yeah.
What you're pointing to, I thought that was the mass airflow sensor, because it's shaped exactly the same as like a GM mass airflow sensor, but it's not. It was the ignition module.
Mm-hmm. Because he took that sensor, he put it here. Okay, let's try just for a while. Fine,
was it? It was running all like garbage and everything.
He said it's probably he just shut down by computer. He shut down the lights, and he said after 3-4 starts, if it's wrong, it's supposed to show up again. But
yeah,
works well.
Well, yeah, of course, because I'm here, right? Just like when you take something to the mechanic.
So he took that from Jetta. We already put it here. No, no, it's already replaced with that one, so.
Yeah, because this is your turbo side, and then the turbo and everything.
Yeah.
So I can see how it'd be a little confusing, but that is the intake side. And
so how do you call that?
It was the ignition module. Ignition module. And, but mine has it like... Like it was like bolt right here.
Yeah.
So I had it was covered up.
Yeah, it's covered up. It's already replaced. Yeah, I know how it looks.
Yeah.
Ignition module.
And I don't even see where it is. But
it looks like this one.
Yeah, that's it right there. Yeah, that's it right there.
It's this one. No, this one over here.
Yeah, that's the mass airflow sensor right there.
This one, yeah.
Yeah.
We replaced that one and...
Because we're... Okay, where did this... this was?
This from Audi. It's from Audi, so... And... same because there was the different connection, and he took my mechanic. He took that sensor from Jetta 2001, and it's fit exactly the same one because it's Jetta Volkswagen.
Yeah,
and we need another one. Okay, there's Jetta, and we need
That is a mass airflow sensor.
Mass airflow.
Yeah, and that is that ignition module.
Mm-hmm. So we need that one.
Just got another Jetta. So this is going to be another project of my many projects to do. Look at the beautiful tires on this thing. Oh, and it looks nice and solid underneath and everything. So I'm going to fix this up to sell it. Engine seems to run pretty good, so, and it's the diesel, of course. It's got a little bit of rust there, but it's good up there, just a little minor defect there. So should be another good car to flip. Gonna have three now. So all in all, today was a good day, other than just getting all scratched up when I fell into that pit. I think I was more shocked than anything, shocked that I didn't get injured. I'm very fortunate that I didn't scrape up a shin or something like that on that little makeshift ladder. But this is an 88 Mercedes, and that's very, very similar to the one that I got in the past. This one has low kilometers. I think it's like 112,000 kilometers on it. So it runs good or something. I'm not really sure why it's getting scrap, other than maybe the body's rotten out on it or something like that. But I don't know. I'll be sure to check it all out. But all in all, another good day, and I can't complain.